Good evening. Investigators are tonight at the scene of a plane crash in Nepal. 68 people are reported dead, including, it's believed, an Australian. Search and rescue crews are still digging through the smouldering remains of the aircraft after it slammed into a valley near the tourist town of Pokhara. Officially, they are still looking for survivors. A warning, this story contains some confronting imagery.
Live streaming with his friends reportedly from inside the cabin of the ill-fated Yeti Flight 691. It would be the final record of this man's life.
Wow.
We've chosen not to show the rest of the clip out of respect for the dead and missing. From the ground, the last seconds were no less harrowing as the plane falls out of the sky. This witness felt the force of the blast. I felt the ground shaking like an earthquake, he described. Those first on the scene desperately scrambled over the twisted, burning wreck of the ATR-72 turboprop. We carried water in buckets and poured water from the road, this man said. We also rescued three injured people, he added. If those people have survived or not is still not clear, but what has been confirmed is that 68 of the 72 on board are dead, one Australian among the missing.
DFAT is providing consular support to the family.
The doomed flight took off from Kathmandu Airport at about 10:30 a.m. local time. It flew the 200 kilometres to Pokhara in less than half an hour, but crashed just after 11 a.m. Watching the phone vision, this aviation expert believes the plane stalled.
Pilots are trained to recover from stalls, but at that level, there's no hope of being able to recover. It may take 1,000 feet or 2,000 feet to recover.
What caused that stall, whether it was pilot error or mechanical failure, is a question investigators hope recordings in the plane's black box will answer. This crash, the latest in a line of aviation disasters in the Himalayan nation. More than 300 people have died in plane crashes in Nepal in the past 23 years, which experts put down to the country's difficult terrain and safety regulations.
So long as the aircraft is well maintained and that the pilots flying the aircraft are well qualified, these sort of accidents just shouldn't happen.
But it did. Now the challenge is to find out why. Samara Gardner for 10 News First.
And there are reports tonight that this is the Australian killed in that plane crash, Sydney man Myron Love. The Department of Foreign Affairs is yet to confirm that he was on board.